Good evening, everyone. This is Jonathan with the National Weather Service and Norman with an updated briefing concerning severe weather potential over the next few days. All right, we continue to mull over the new data that continues to stream in this evening, and the overall forecast remains unchanged. So we'll make this a quick update for you, as Mark did a great job with the previous briefing this afternoon. For the most part, you should have great weather for any Mother's Day festivities you have planned in the morning or early afternoon. We still expect storms to develop in the late afternoon, continuing into Monday as the front swings through the region. We would like you to remain aware that there could be an increased threat of flash flooding in some locations with the strongest storms. Overall, most will get some rainfall, with the heaviest amounts expected across south central and southeastern Oklahoma. Okay, by late afternoon, isolated storms are expected to develop over portions of northern and western Oklahoma. Additional storms are likely to develop as we head into the evening. Initially, the storms are likely to be high-based and pose mainly a large hail and damaging wind threat, but conditions will slowly evolve to become more supportive of tornado development as we near sunset across northern and western Oklahoma. This does not mean every storm will be tornadic, it just means conditions may be conducive. New storms will continue to develop through Sunday evening and into the overnight hours. Initially, discrete storms will slowly merge into one or more storm clusters. Stronger storms may continue to produce very large hail and damaging wind gusts. As storms develop into clusters, the training of storms over the same area may lead to localized flash flooding. Any storm that remains isolated from around 7 p.m. through 10 p.m. will continue to carry some threat of producing a tornado, although the threat will gradually diminish through nightfall. Overnight, with the track of the upper-level storm system eastward, one or more clusters of storms will congeal and slowly move east with the cold front. Stronger storm cells within this greater area of convection will continue to pose a threat of large hail and damaging winds. Heavy rainfall will become more of a concern over portions of south-central and southeastern Oklahoma, leading to possible flash flooding and/or flooding of low-lying and poorly drained areas. Through Monday morning, the severe potential will slowly wind down, though a hail and wind threat will persist. Flooding will be the main concern as training storms produce heavy rainfall over the same areas. Here is the current rainfall forecast through 7 p.m. Tuesday. Remember, this is just a broad forecast and it does not take into consideration localized effects or isolated heavy rainfall from thunderstorms. Some will see more and some will see less than what is depicted by this graphic. Again, Mark has mentioned it in the previous briefings. We're used to severe storms this time of year, so you shouldn't be afraid. Just make sure you have a plan in case severe weather threatens your area. Check back with us frequently as things usually change. Make sure you have some way to receive severe weather information while not at home, such as a cell phone or a portable weather radio. Always have multiple ways to receive warnings and don't wait for outdoor warning sirens to alert you to an impending hazard. They are not intended for people indoors. Those of you traveling need to take extra caution. Sometimes postponing a trip is the smartest move one can make. And remember, if you come across a flooded roadway, turn around, don't drown. Thanks again for watching. As always, the best place to find the most accurate and up-to-date forecast and warning information for western and central Oklahoma and western North Texas is on our webpage at weather.gov/Norman. You may also wish to view forecasts and warnings for other areas that may see severe weather this weekend, including Tulsa, Fort Worth, Wichita, Dodge City, Topeka, and Kansas City. We also hope you will like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thanks again, please stay safe, and we'd like to take this time once again to wish all the moms out there a wonderful Mother's Day, and to all the graduates out there, congratulations. Have a great weekend.